And new tonight, a bull elk in captivity after it was illegally raised in Sweet, Idaho. What Fish and Game says is supposed to be a wild animal now may have to be held captive the rest of its life. And CBS2's Alexis Gorey is live. She's in Boise to explain why they made this decision and what's next for this elk.
After capturing this elk, Idaho Fish and Game released it into the wild because they thought it was the right thing to do. But they quickly found out all this elk wanted to do was be around humans.
There he is, the big bull.
It was just a matter of seconds. He was like to the vehicle and he stuck his nose right inside the side window and totally caught Tony and I by surprise.
He just needed a scratch.
A shock to many that this 400-pound bull elk actually wanted to interact with humans.
It was unusual to see what was supposed to be a wild animal come up to us. That never happens.
That's because this elk was illegally raised by a family in Sweet, Idaho. Fish and Game say Elliot, named by the people of Sweet, was captured as a calf last spring, but was let go for the winter.
We got a number of phone calls from folks in the community of Sweet that this elk was camping on people's porches, chasing kids down the street.
That's when Fish and Game officers knew they had to get him out. They reached out to see if any accredited facilities would take him, but no luck. So they decided to give him a second chance at freedom.
It wasn't integrating into a herd. It preferred to be around people.
With hunting season starting, Evan O'Neill says this is not a good situation for hunters or the animals. So now he says emotions are running high. They now have to deal with a situation that could have been prevented.
That actually is the problem. The elk was habituated to people, was used to being around them. And we have the rut coming on, which is the breeding season for elk. And the bulls particularly get very nasty that time of year. It's part of their natural process.
O'Neill says they decided to find the elk a home at an accredited facility for conservation and education. And they're not alone in that decision. Save Elliot has spread like wildfire.
Our goal is to see Elliot live a long, fruitful life and that he can be used for education purposes, that the public can learn the story about Elliot and how we can deal with animals that may be found in a situation like Elliot for the future.
And there is a lesson to be learned.
Wild animals belong in the wild. And so if you find a baby animal out there on the ground somewhere, it's better if you just leave it where it is.
It's not a sad story. It actually has a happy ending. And the story of Elliot and his survival is what's important.
The problem, O'Neill says, elk are common, but he does say that they do have a couple of leads to get this elk farmed out to an accredited facility, and they have folks like the Schindlers to make sure that he gets to a new and safe home. Live in Boise, Alexis Gorey, CBS 2 News.